It's 4:30 in the morning. It's dark. It's snowing. It's dreary. It's wet. It's disgusting outside here in Washington, D.C. And I've got a tip for a beautiful big wall to hunt down. And we're going to Hollywood, California, here in bright, sunny, beautiful L.A., home to some of President Trump's biggest critics, people who hate the immigration policy of this administration, people who hate Trump's wall, people who think it's racist. How do they live? They live right here. And there's no better way to tour the homes of the rich and famous than with our very own American Caravan. Beautiful, sunny Southern California, we will be bringing you wall-to-wall coverage here in Los Angeles for Walls Across America. We are here in front of a fantastic wall, all right? This thing is massive. It's really big. It has signs that says you're on camera. It's got security, clearly. This wall belongs to none other than one of Donald Trump's harshest critics in all of media and all of comedy and all of entertainment. His name's Jimmy Kimmel.
He did not make mention of the caravan that was coming to get us 3 months ago. I don't know what happened to that.
I'm trying to get the caravan in, but there's no way we're getting in there. No way the caravan's getting into Jimmy Kimmel's house. Can't see anything. And there you have it. We are here in LA bringing you wall-to-wall coverage. So, my God, we have arrived at perhaps the greatest wall yet. Look at this thing. This is magnificent. Its walls have walls. There's multiple walls, multiple layers. It's 20 feet tall, no doubt about it. It's huge. This is the wall to end all walls, my God. And it belongs to one of my favorite anti-Trump comedians, Chelsea Handler.
I would like to apologize on behalf of the entire Trump administration. We're sorry for making it clear that white supremacists and Nazis are welcome in this country, while young, hardworking immigrants brought here as children are not.
She is making sure that the things that she loves, things that she wants to protect, is protected by a massive wall. I mean, look at it. Come here, walk with me. Multiple levels, right? Like a little bit of some honeybees, some flowers, and then another giant wall on top of that wall. Okay? This is so smart, all right? In my wall hunting years, I have never seen a wall so special. There does happen to also be a big, beautiful gate, all right? Right there. Fantastic. A port of entry, you might call it. Caravan would have run right into a wall. This wall, I mean, it's a beauty. It's a beauty. I love it. Donald Trump should take notes from Chelsea Handler. This wall has its own walls, it has shrubberies, it has multiple levels of defense, it has security cameras, it has security electronic. Whoa, okay? This is amazing. Good job. Great wall, Chelsea. Wall to wall coverage, all right? Behind us, an amazing wall. Truly a magnificent wall. A wall that incorporates something that Donald Trump actually uses to defend our borders, barbed wire. We have a barbed wire wall behind us and a gate. Looks like a metal gate. It's iron, it has meshing on it, and it has barbed wire across the top. Hoo boy, that's the daddy of them all. It belongs to none other than one of Trump's absolute harshest, most leftist critics ever in Hollywood, Rob Reiner.
Let's cut to the chase. This is about racism. This is pure and simple racism. That's all this is. He's hoping that the people who support him will be ginned up and running to the polls to make sure that brown people don't come into America. That's exactly what's going on here.
Really hates Donald Trump's border wall, really hates the policy, and it's unfair to say it belongs to Rob Reiner. His house is in the development behind us. Barbed wire stopped the migrant caravan at the border, and it's definitely stopping our caravan. And if I tried to climb over, ow! Meathead, open this gate! This is a legal port of entry. Take down this hateful barrier. Rob Reiner chooses to protect the treasures and the places and the properties he loves with a wall and barbed wire on the top of it. That is wall-to-wall coverage. We are here in a beautiful neighborhood in Los Angeles, outside of a house that has an awesome wall. I would tell you that it would be extremely effective, except for the person who lives here can absolutely, definitely, 100% see over it. This is LeBron James's house. Brought ourselves a caravan. It's not getting in because there's a mixture of cameras, electronic security, brick security, iron gates, iron slats, and basketball hoops keeping us from getting into LeBron's house. LeBron, again, very much critical of the president on immigration, very much critical of the president's immigration policies, and has been so effusively since almost the beginning of the administration. However, LeBron chooses to protect his castle, like a king, with a big old wall. Mock wall-ing, wall, bird, wall, 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 to wall coverage. You are not going to believe the majesty we just found here in the hills of Los Angeles. Look at this. This is a huge, giant natural wall. Look at how big this is. This giant wall here belongs to one of the funniest men in all of Hollywood, and one of Donald Trump's biggest critics. His name is Jim Carrey. Massive, massive hedge around a really big compound. Compound has, right here, an enormous wall. We got cameras, we got a giant gate. Keeps going though. That's what's crazy. This is a massive, massive compound. And then gets into actual brick, and gets into actually like wooden wall with more plants, more fern, more foliage. This is the port of entry, right here, at Jim Carrey's wall. That is a massive wall! Somebody stop me! All righty then, wall-to-wall coverage. We are up here in Malibu now, and we are here in front of a fantastic wall that I don't think, you know, the force could even move. And this is the wall of Luke Skywalker. Trying to climb this would be like trying to get into the Death Star. No! To get a caravan through that gate, you'd have to be a stuck-up, half-witted, scruffy-headed nerf herder. The best part, it's just like Donald Trump's. Steel slats up and down on the border. You can see through to the other side. That's really important for border security and border patrol. Mark Hamill is actually one of Donald Trump's biggest critics. He is really critical of immigration policy and the wall. Really doesn't like it, tweets about it a lot. May the wall be with you here at Luke Skywalker's house. Wall-to-wall coverage. We have been hunting walls across LA all day long. It's 5 o'clock here in LA for our white whale, for the wall of them all. Barbara Streisand's wall.
Every time this president said something that wasn't true, I just had to eat pancakes.
Barbara Streisand got herself a big old wall. She is one of Trump's biggest critics on immigration, on building a wall, but she herself has a beautiful, beautiful wall and a beautiful gate where you can knock and ask to come inside. This has been a long day of wall-to-wall coverage here in sunny Los Angeles. We've seen some of the biggest celebrities in the industry, some of the biggest sports stars in the industry, some of the biggest critics of President Trump and his immigration policy. How do they choose to protect the things that they love? With a wall. All of them. So the question for America, how do you choose to protect what you love? We'll see you next time on the next episode of Walls Across America. Walls Across America. We love this series. We know you love this series. Tell us down below, where do you want us to go next? We love these walls. These things are awesome, amazing walls. Boy, oh boy, who has the best wall? Let's find out. Tell us where to go, and we'll go there on Walls Across America. Keep tuning in. Thank you.